Today we're going to be trying out three new hats for the Raspberry Pi 5. I've used variants of each of these on my Pi 4 setups for a few years now, and I think that these are the most handy hats to keep around for my Pi projects. First up is the X1003 NVMe hat, and you can pick one of these up online for around $15. I tested three other NVMe hats a few months ago. I'll leave a link to that video in the description, but this was one that I was told about after making the video. I primarily like that it's compact and simple. This leaves a lot of room around the hat for cooling. The main drawbacks with the others I've tested is that the bottom mount ones tend to enclose the drive and cause the drive to run hot, and the top ones tend to restrict airflow to the cooler. This hat keeps both the drive and the fan open. There is one strange design choice, and that's that it requires an active cooler to be installed on the Pi, because it's supported along its edge by picking up on one of the screw holes. I don't really know why they went with this approach rather than picking up on one of the Pi's mounting holes with a standoff. I assume they wanted to keep those free. In terms of drive options, you can only use 2230 and 2242 size drives in it. It connects to the Pi with an FPC cable and gets additional power from the GPIO pins. I tested this hat out using James Chambers' Pi benchmark script and a Sabrent Rocket NVMe SSD. I got an average score over three tests of 42,457, which is a good result given that I've left the Pi's PCIe port running at the default Gen 2 speed. It is comparable to the drive running at Gen 2 speeds in the other hats that I've tested. The hat will also fit into the official Pi 5 case with the fan plate removed, and the active cooler will then take care of keeping the Pi CPU cool. Next up is an NVMe and PoE hat by Hacker Gadgets, which you can get online for $43. This is a Power over Ethernet or PoE hat designed for the Pi 5 that isn't much larger than the official PoE hat for the Pi 4, but it also includes an M.2 port for an NVMe drive that makes use of the Pi 5's PCIe port. This hat allows you to use a PoE switch or PoE injector to power your Pi using the connected network cable rather than having to use a separate power adapter as well, so it simplifies your setup and allows you to use fewer cables. If you're running a headless arrangement like you would on a NAS or Pi hole project, then you only need an Ethernet cable and your Pi is good to go. It's PoE Plus or PoE Type 2, which means that it can handle a higher power delivery than the original PoE standard, typically up to 25 watts instead of the original 12.5 watts. This hat's switch mode power supply can supply 5 volts at up to 4.8 amps, so up to 24 watts. It's also got an additional USB-C power port on the back, and you can use this to power or charge an external device. It's also got a cutout in the PCB that you can either use to mount a 30mm fan or install over the active cooler, and it'll still allow airflow through to the fan. Like the previous hat, this one's also compatible with 2230 and 2242 size drives. The hat plugs into the GPIO pins to supply power to the Pi, and then it's got an FPC cable to connect the NVMe drive. It's also got a 4-pin connector at the front that picks up power from the Ethernet port. Now we don't need to hook up a USB-C power cable to the Pi, as it'll get power from the Ethernet connection. Upon booting up, I got a warning that the supply is not capable of supplying 5 amps. This comes up because the Pi isn't able to carry out the power delivery negotiation while booting up, because the hat's powering it through the GPIO pins. You can disable this check in firmware by manually setting PSU max current to 5000. To test this hat, I ran two different tests, one on the NVMe drive and one on the CPU. I again tested the NVMe drive using James Chambers' Pi benchmark script and a Sabrent Rocket NVMe SSD. I got slightly better results than with the previous hat, with an average score of 43,550, again at Gen 2 speeds. I also tested it by running CPU burn to load up the CPU to make sure that the PoE power supply was capable of handling a full CPU load. It ran for 10 minutes without any issues and without thermal throttling. PoE hats tend to run quite hot, but this one doesn't seem to have had a significant effect on the Pi. This hat is also compatible with the official Pi 5 case. The last hat is very similar to one that I used in my Pi 4 server build a while back, and that's an X1200 UPS hat, which you can get online for $42. This hat stores power into 18650 cells on the bottom, and then provides uninterruptible power to the Pi through the GPIO and power circuit pins. Also on the bottom are some additional 5 volt power supply connectors and a power button. On the top, we've got a USB Type-C power input, which takes the Power5's official 5V 5A power supply. We've also got a charging LED and a battery voltage indicator. There are two more status LEDs on the other edge. The Power5 one tells you when the Power5 is powered on, and the one alongside it tells you when the hat is on. The hat uses some cleverly designed pogo pins to make contact with the PIUS pins from underneath it. So with this hat on the bottom, you've then got room on top to put an active cooler and a top-mounted NVMe hat. I'm going to add this NVMe hat to the setup as our boot drive. Once installed, the Pi can boot up from the batteries if they're charged. And you then provide power to the UPS rather than the Pi to keep them charged. There is a script that you can install that'll provide UPS stats to the Pi via its I2C interface. This will also tell the Pi to safely shut down if the battery voltage drops below a configurable level. When the mains power is removed, the UPS continues to provide power to the Pi, like in the beginning when it was running off the batteries only. The length of time that it can run will obviously depend on the capacity of the batteries and what you've got connected to your Pi, but you should be able to get about an hour or two from a set of 3000mAh batteries. This hat is too big for the official case, but there are a couple of other case options available for it, including one of my own designs. Let me know in the comments section if you've used any of these hats on your own projects, or if there are any other hats for the Pi 5 that you'd like me to try out. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe for more tech and electronics projects, tutorials, and reviews.